Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. Have you ever had an Illustrator file that changes colors every time you open it, place it, or paste something in? My name is Monika, and in this video, we're going to take a look at that. So I've got this TIFF file, which is an RGB file, and it has some bright colors in it. And in the info panel, you see all these nice and round values for those colors. This is nice. Let's get this into Illustrator. And we are going to create a new file, just a standard web file, create it, and then let's file place the TIFF. This is it. I'm not going to link it. I'm going to embed it and place it. And there it is. Okay, nice. So let's pick the colors. I'm going to create a rectangle and then take the eyedropper tool and shift click on this color. And you see, well, that's not quite what I've ordered. Let's try the other ones. And all of them have changed. They are no longer the nice values I entered in there. So what gives? What is happening here? Illustrator didn't throw any warning, anything at all. But still, those colors look somewhat like what I wanted. So when you pull up the Photoshop, beside of that, that looks the same, right? You can't notice it. But why is it? So to understand that, we first need to look at what color is. And to do that, we are going to look at what do these numbers mean. So these RGB numbers, and the same goes for CMYK numbers, the RGB numbers are not absolute. They refer to points in a specific space. And depending on the space, they mean something different. So let's take a look at the color spaces. And to do that, I'm going to pull up Apple's Color Sync utility. And there we can look at color spaces. So let's go to Adobe RGB. And you see this is a color space. It's a three-dimensional space. It's a very large color space, Adobe RGB. And in this Color Sync utility, we can compare it to other spaces. You see there are some different ones. So we can go in here and hold it for comparison. And then let's go to sRGB. And when working in web design, of course, you have heard of sRGB because it's the color space most web design is happening in. It's the lowest common denominator. So it's kind of small. And you see it's here displayed inside Adobe RGB. And it's a lot smaller, but both of them have the same numbers. So those numbers obviously mean something different in both of these spaces. That must be the case. And of course, if you want to refer to the same color, then that also means the same color in both spaces, if even possible, have different numbers. Because some of the colors that are possible to display in Adobe RGB are not possible to display in sRGB. So these don't happen in the other color space. Now, what does that mean for the Illustrator file? The same thing that we have experienced when placing this TIFF file also happens when you copy something. So we have the same colors in this file here. And let's take all of them and copy them and then paste them. And you see, they have changed as well. They have been converted. And again, Illustrator didn't warn us. So why that? At the bottom of each desktop publishing or any publishing application, color management works. And color management is there to handle all these different color spaces and to do conversions. So in order to achieve the same color impression from start to finish. But when you depend on the same color numbers from start to finish, then this might get in your way and you might set it up in a way that it doesn't do what you want it to do. So let's go to it. Edit, color settings, in there we've got it. And it can set up in a wildly weird way so that it will ruin anything you do with it. So let's take a look at it. Now, the important thing, the warnings. So you might have seen those warnings when you open a file and Illustrator says, well, that's a different color profile, so what should I do? And maybe you said, well, Illustrator, it's kind of pesky and you turn them off. But that's the first thing, the first step into disaster. So turn on all of these. So when doing anything and there are different color spaces, Illustrator will pop up a warning. Important. The next thing is I've set it up to convert. So not only does it not warn you that there's something different, but also it converts without asking. And this, of course, will convert the numbers. So what you want is preserve the embedded profiles. The next thing is you want your working space set up to something that makes sense. So this is the color space of my monitor. And you want this set up to sRGB. Or if you're working in Adobe RGB, set it up to Adobe RGB. But when doing web design, sRGB makes a lot of more sense. So let's go to OK. The next thing is the color profiles that are embedded in your documents. So when setting up my next Illustrator file, it will take the color profile that I have set up in the color settings. So my next Illustrator document will be in sRGB. All the documents I have set up before, they should get a different color profile so that this won't happen again. So you need to assign profiles. When you assign a profile in Illustrator, you won't convert the colors. You just assign a different profile. What you also need to set up, in case you have turned off the warnings forever by checking this don't show again checkbox, you have to reset that. To do that, you go into Illustrator Preferences General and click on Reset All Warning Dialogs so that all the warnings show up again. The next thing is when doing web design, you're working with screenshots a lot. So you import a screenshot into Illustrator or even open a screenshot in Illustrator. And screenshots these days have color profiles embedded. So what you also need to do is take your image files. This is the file in Photoshop. And again, you can assign a profile. Again, when using a screenshot and you want to preserve the color numbers, do not convert to profile, but assign a profile. And you see this one has a monitor profile embedded as well, because that's what happens with screenshots. So every time you take a screenshot, you have to do this and change the color profile that's embedded in it. And when you have a group of collaborators on a job, make sure they are all set up the same and they all use the same color profiles in their screenshots. And this needs to be set to sRGB as well, so that we have the same profiles embedded in these files and that the conversions don't happen. So these are the settings you have to watch out for in order to prevent the conversion of your color numbers. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.